$56.36 that we spent on lunch. Baby, come back.
Lush. I don't even know how much we spent.
Yours was 136, and I feel like mine was a little less than 100. 200.
How much? 175.
Hold up, we're calculating how much this actually costs. So 136 plus 175, 311. Hold up, 311 pounds in Canadian dollars. In total, both of us have spent $528.18 at Lush. You're supposed to spend $6 at Lush for one Bath Bomb. Nope.
And that was with a discount too.
Yeah.
It was probably more.
How much was the discount?
Okay, so I'm reading online. The discount, it says, reported anonymously by Lush employees, employee discounts is an enormous 50%. So 528.18 times two, $1,056.36 that we spent on lunch. Oh my God. We have a problem. Okay, we're gonna show you everything that we got.
Hold time. Two things that I'm really excited about that I think that we should show first is the stuff that we made. So we went to the Lush showcase, and it was just basically a convention where people like Lush employees can go and they can make bath bombs, they can listen to panels, they can buy amazing things, buy exclusive things, things that are not even going to be sold in the stores. So the thing that Rose and I were most excited about when we went to the Lush showcase is making our own products. In this bad boy, we made two things. Okay, I have to show you Rosie's situation. So
I had to buy a new suitcase just so I could put my clothes in it and then keep my old suitcase just for the Lush stuff.
Oh dear.
So we made these bath bombs. They let us do any color that we would like. And of course, Rosie did a really cool one.
Hers was all blue and like green. And mine is all yellow. They said that we have to leave this in the, what do you call this? The mold for 2 to 4 days and then we can use it. So leaving it in the mold until it gets all hard. And that was our goal. The entire weekend we were like, all I want to do is make a bath bomb. And we did it the last day, literally the last couple hours of the showcase.
And with the other one, they have like 3 things left. And uh-huh.
We just were able to do it because they were about to run out of product. Okay, so we made these. These are the ectoplasm naked shower gel. So they have zero packaging. And they already made this yellow thing. And we just had to dip the black mold into it so that you can like hold it and it doesn't melt. Yeah. It's very citrusy. Yeah. And I think that this glows in the dark, so you have to charge it in the sun, and then
And then it glows in the dark if you're having a bath in the dark or a shower in the dark.
Mine's kind of messy, but like I love her.
I kind of messed up. It's not really perfect, but
that's what makes her personal.
We got those 3 things. These were my favorite because they were custom, and we made it. And we had the experience behind it, the memories behind it. So when I use that bath bomb, I'm not gonna be like, oh, I love this bath bomb. I'm gonna be like, I put my hard work, blood, sweat, and tears into this bath bomb. So everything. So I tried to get the most exclusive stuff that I can that you can't buy at any Lush store, only at the showcase. I got the merch. The merch is exclusive to the showcase. So I got this makeup bag, and I have a shirt like this from last year. I really like it. You never have enough makeup bags. Or I can even just put bath bombs in here, hair stuff, travel stuff.
Oh, we got the same thing.
Did we?
Yeah.
Matching. I love that.
I got this bag. It was also on a patch, but I don't use patches.
Oh, I like it. And it's yellow.
Lush.
Oh, I thought that was at the front.
Double sided. We got these Lush jumpers.
Yay. I just like it because it was black and I got it in a, what size did you get?
I don't know. I didn't even check. I got it in a medium.
But I got it in a large so it could be like oversized.
I like it because it has like the logo.
It has the logo on it.
That one's so cute. I didn't even see that.
I got like a plant life one.
I love that.
We both got this. I don't know if you have yours. We're like the opposite race of our. We got these coffee cups because Lush had this thing and it said 160 water bottles or coffee cups are thrown out every 2 seconds in the UK only. That's crazy. Every 2 seconds, 160 cups. Crazy. So
we got these trying to be eco-friendly.
And they had that thing and it was like you can only get tea and coffee here if you have
the reusable thing.
Which was really good because it was like making everyone buy one.
Yeah. Next up, I've used this before and I love it, but since Lush's products are so fresh, their things go bad. So I got this brand new Sunny Day Anti-Static Hair Detangler, and I really love this because my natural hair gets really tangled and frizzy. So love this. Also, it's called Sunny Day. Love sun, yellow, sunshine.
and stuff like that. And it's a new packaging.
I don't know the name of anything because I didn't get labels.
Oh no!
It's something about energy. That was in the name. Adeline got it too, I think.
Oh yeah!
It smells like lemons and yum. It's a body conditioner.
It's called Little Pot of Energy.
I knew there was energy in there somewhere.
Little Pot of Energy. So, Rosie and I are both obsessed with Ariana Grande. So we both got two of each.
The other one's in my suitcase, but yeah.
The Goddess of Woman Bath Bomb. Ta-da! This is my favorite thing that we got at the showcase.
Yeah, same.
And I want to put one in the bath tonight. And we saw it at the showcase. We put it in the water and it looked like the music video.
I was like, ooh, I'm gonna be Ariana with this. Whoa, this is really sparkly.
Oh my god, I wish I got more bubble bars.
Is this a bubble bar?
I think so.
It's like a, what is it? Like a maca?
Oh,
something.
Yeah, a rose macaroon bubble bar.
That's
something
it.
Like that.
Yeah, and it smells like rose petals.
Also, life hack, if you're too broke to buy Lush, girl, put your shampoo in your bath and it'll make bubbles. Life hack. That's what Tiffany and I did when we were in the hotel. We wanted to take a cute bubble photo and we were like, I don't have any Lush bath bombs. Tiffany was like, don't you fear, we got shampoo. This thing I was really, really, really excited about. They didn't have a label on it because I'm pretty sure that it was exclusive to the showcase, so you can't buy it anywhere else. But girl, this was an 18 pound, and by pound I mean like dollar, not 18 like pounds. But this is a huge bath bomb. Inside of this bath bomb, I don't want to ruin it, I'll do a whole vlog on it, but inside of this bath bomb is flower petals, so when you put it in the bath, it's gonna fizz, and then you have flowers in it. It's gonna be very aesthetically pleasing.
Were you able to pick them?
Yeah.
What ones do you pick? Sunflower ones?
I think so.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. But look at the size of the regular bath bomb compared to this one.
It's huge, and they were everywhere. I went to the Christmas range, even though it's like September.
But you got all your Christmas stuff early.
Yeah. And I got two of these, so
yeah. I also went to the Christmas range, and I got something that I've been wanting for so, so, so long. You guys know I love sweet scents, so I got the Snow Fairy body spray.
Girl!
The lady was like, can I spray you? And I was like, spray me. I'm not gonna take the thing off because I'm traveling with it, but she was like, it smelled like I was the cotton candy. I love smelling like cotton candy. I love smelling like sugar. But I feel like it's not good because when I smell sugar, I crave sugar.
Ooh, karma. Girl, what the heck?
That literally sounded like someone's trying to break into
the window.
Do you hear that?
Oh. I was going like that. We're cheering that part. She'd be like,
I was just like,
Rosie, is it okay if you add music like this? But now I'm like telling you. Karma, I've heard about that so much.
What does it smell like? Is that spicy?
Yeah.
Like a spicy
cinnamon
smell?
Spice?
Yeah.
Kind of.
I've never got one before and I don't really know why, but I got one today because I really like it.
Oh my god. That was... Why are we like this? Okay, I got two patches. I'm gonna get room service. Oh,
hello.
Be a guest. Put the service to the test. Oh my god.
You're
that looks so
like
good.
A professional British person.
I know.
You've got fish and chips.
I love fish and chips.
I love mostly the chips, aka fries.
You look so bougie.
Yeah. Jeffree Star here. Doing makeup in my hotel room with room service. Bye bye.
We're back and bloated.
So cool.
So there was this really, really, really nice lady who was giving away little Lush charms at the event.
This is her little Instagram handle. It's iArtCandy.
If you want to check out her Instagram. And she gave away these little charms to Rosie and I.
They're so cute.
Man on the moon and a little penguin.
And Rosie put hers on her makeup bag. It looks really, really, really cute. Also from the gift shop, I got, so Rosie had this shirt and I got on a patch. This is Be Fresh Lush Cosmetics patch and then just the regular Lush Cosmetics patch to put on my suitcase because I love putting on my suitcase so that when it goes around in the little thingy-majigger, people will be like, oh, this is mine. And I'll be like, no, it's not. Do you have a Lush patch on yours? So yeah, less likely to be stolen.
They had so much soap, right?
Yeah.
It was everywhere. So I got so much soap.
So this is the sandstone soap. So I got this guy. Originally, I wanted the honey I washed the kids soap, but it was sold out. But this one, first of all, is yellow. And second of all, smells like citrus. And I really love the smell of citrus. So I grabbed that.
Next, we got these like,
oh, I need to show my.
We got these like tested on us.
I can't tell. Because he's like, I need to edit all of this. Okay, so this is called Black Stocking Body Butter.
I don't know what this is cool, but it's basically the same.
And it looks like this. And the reason why we got this is because the lady swatched it on us. Let me show you. So you go like this. Mm-hmm. It not only moisturizes it, but it also makes you have a little tan and it makes you glow. Boop, 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 boop. I don't know if you can really tell.
You can kind of see it. It's almost like a body highlight.
Mm-hmm. So really like that. I like looking like a bronze goddess without actually tanning because when I tan, my laser lady gets really mad at me because she's like, like, I can't laser you! Because, fun fact, if I get too tan, the laser will zap my skin instead of zapping the hair on my leg. Because the laser is attracted to the pigmentation of my hair, I think. Ooh. So it'll be attracted to the pigmentation of my skin. And then, yeah.
It's probably wrong, but...
So, we got these highlighters. These are Lush's brand new highlighters. They're brand new makeup. So, Rosie got, I think...
I don't know what one I got.
Ta-da! But, girl, this is Lush's brand new highlighter. It goes like this. Boop, 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 boop. I feel like it's showing it weird because it's on my foundation. Girl, why is it... It looks so good in person, but, like, on camera, it looks so bad.
Here you can kind of see it. Boop, 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 boop.
So, I got three colors. I got Ibis, which is the one I just washed. Everyone was obsessed with this one. This one is Peacock. It's a green highlighter. You guys are probably like, green, Adeline. Like, green's not gonna look good on my skin. Hold up.
Oh, girl. You can't see the shimmer. Whoa, oh my God.
Oh my God.
Do you see though? Oh my God. It's more so glitter as opposed to shimmer, but oh, there you go. Ooh.
Okay, last one is Goldfinch. And this one was a gold one. Ta-da! Thought this would be a good natural highlighter because I got some crazy colors. I got pink, I got green, and now we're gonna have a yellow highlighter. We blend it.
It looks like this. That is the gold, that is the green, that is the pink. Gold, green, pink.
Next up, I got one of the Lush foundations. So these are the Lush slapsticks. And they come in 40 different shades. And girl, they're not. I feel like they have a decent skin range from like very light to medium to very dark. So I picked 24W because I feel like I have warm skin. And this has naked packaging, meaning that you don't throw anything away other than this. Obviously, you recycle this. And it looks like a little beauty blender, and you're supposed to put this on your face. And I don't know, I haven't tried it on my face yet. I'm really excited to try it. I'm really excited because Lush said that last year they were gonna make new makeup, and this year they did. And at the showcase, they had concealers, but they weren't available to purchase. They were just to test out and to like play with because like, they weren't finished formulas yet, but I would have bought it. And apparently they were a lot more pigmented than the foundation sticks, and they were a lot skinnier so that you can get those like areas with your face. You know, stuff like that. So yeah, foundation. Okay, Rosie's back hurts, but this is everything else that she got.
I'm literally 90. I can't stand and sit and like show everything.
But I have a couple things left in my bag. One thing that I was really excited about is this packaging. I know it's so weird, but it looks like this is kind of like a cork. Oh dear, I didn't think of this. Oh no. I'll figure out how to take it out, but this is a solid shampoo bar. So, you guys are used to like, squirt, squirt, put in your hair and then shampoo. But this is a shampoo bar, so you go like, beep, 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 bop. And this one, I think, was honey. I washed the kids, so it was honey flavored. And then for the conditioner, I got a solid conditioner as well. This is the Sugar Daddy-O Solid Conditioner. And the lady recommended this to me because I do have highlights in my hair and they are a bit brassy. So this is a toning hair conditioner because obviously it's purple, so it's gonna turn my yellow hair more kind of like neutral colored. Even though I do love yellow, but I don't really love brassy yellow hair. Not the vibe. Same with yellow teeth. Not the vibe. Some things are just not beautiful yellow. Sorry. So I got this hair conditioner to go with the solid shampoo. And I thought that they would be good for traveling because the most annoying thing is when you're traveling and then your shampoo spills all over the place. But girl, you don't even have to worry about it with these because they're solid. The next thing, it was also an exclusive at the showcase. This is the Goldfinger Brush Strokes. I think this is a face wash. Face mask. So you're supposed to put this on. Oh, girl, it's gold. It's about to spill right now. Listen to this. This product description is so bougie. When your face is a canvas, only gold will do. Cedarwood and all libanum blend with rose and bergamot for a luxurious and elegant fragrance. Oh. I think you're supposed to keep this refrigerated, so you should put that in the refrigerator. Next up, I got the Snow Fairy Lip Scrub. My lips are always super, super, super dry, and I love this the most. Smells amazing. Next up, this is the Hottie Massage Bar. So I got this because Matt, he complains about his back. He's always broken. His leg hurts. His arms hurt. His back hurts. Whatever. So this is a massage bar meant to loosen up your muscles. It looks like this. It looks kind of like an egg carton. Or like Ariana Grande in God is a Woman when she's like... But it's melting in my hands right now. It smells kind of musky. I don't really know what it's supposed to smell like, but got that mostly for Matt. And then this next one is called a King of Skin Body Butter Crown. I love this because, okay, so situation, you're shaving your legs, okay? You're getting ready to go out, maybe go see your man, maybe go see your dog, walk your dog, whatever. You shave, and then afterwards you rub this boopity-bop all over your leg. Your legs will be so, 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 so soft. I've never had softer legs other than when I've used this. This is amazing. Last thing.
All that's left in the bag is the receipt.
This is the scrubby body butter. So this is almost the same thing as King of Skin body butter crown. Love the scrubby, smells like honey. The Lush employee was going on and on and on about how well they treat their bees. She was so sweet. She said she could talk about it for days, and girl, she could. She's talking about it a lot. I feel like Lush employees are just so passionate about what they do because it is an amazing company. I love Lush. But yeah, love the way that scrubby smells. He's so cutie.
It has a cocoa butter, shea butter, coconut shell, ground almonds, all that good stuff. So underneath it'll, I think it'll exfoliate you. Not 100% sure.
But that was everything that Rosie and I got at the showcase. Ended up being a total of too much.
But yeah.
Oh my god, can I also show you what I got in the room? So when I first came into the hotel room, my friend from Lush, Nicole, gave me a little bag of their new product set that I want to promote. So I got four things. I got, this is Monster Ball Bath Bomb. Oh, it kind of got wet. But this is part of their Halloween line, which I'm so excited about. So this is the little guy. He's a Monster Ball Bath Bomb. He looks very colorful. I'm so excited to put in the bath and for him to be so colorful. And then next up we have, this is the Eyeball Bath Bomb. It's very straight to the point because it literally just looks like an eyeball. And I think I saw a Snapchat story of it, and in the bath it looks kind of black. Excited about that. That's gonna be so cool for Halloween. And then next up we got the BB Seaweed Fresh Face Mask. It smells exactly how you'd think it smells, just like seaweed. And then I love this one. So this is the Cupcake Face Mask. I've used this before. It smells literally like chocolate. It's literally like putting chocolate on your face. You'll look like the little Poopoo Man emoji when you put it on, but it is amazing. It smells amazing. And then lastly, they gave us one more bag. This says Lush Labs on it. It's a reusable bag. I've been trying to use more reusable bags when I go to the grocery store. I even ordered some. I keep them in my car. I'm trying to do the same with straws. I try to keep the straws in my car, but I keep using them and then I just don't put it back in my car and then I end up not having straws, but that's off the topic. First of all, you guys already seen this. They gave us the Ariana Grande bath bomb. Well, Ariana Grande inspired bath bomb. This is the goddess bath bomb. Bath ballistic is what it's technically called because I don't know if I said this to you guys before, but when you search Ariana Grande bath bomb, it turns out as Ariana Grande bomb. And then you see the Manchester stuff. So they're trying to be sensitive with this and they're trying to call this just the goddess ballistic, not bath bomb. But yeah, it is a bath bomb. They just call it ballistic. I kind of want to do a bath right now. And then this is the Ghost in the Dark soap. So this is again with their Halloween line. It looks like this. It's not supposed to be purple. It's just purple because of the packaging and I left it out in the sun. But this is the Ghost. I feel like it smells kind of musky. This is what I want Matt to smell like. I don't know how else to describe it. It's kind of like musky vanilla. And then we got Not Sleepy Shower Bomb. I've never tried a shower bomb before. I don't know how to use a shower bomb. Just add water and your shower bomb will foam up into a soft fragrant mousse and you can even sween all over to cleanse the skin. So this is what it looks like. Of course, it's yellow. Citrusy. Smells like lemons. I love that. Maybe I'll use that today too. Oh, I also got a paintbrush because there was like a makeup station. They required you to have a paintbrush. And then also the cutest subscriber came to the Lush showcase and she gave me a little note. You can pause it if you want to read it, but it's the cutest little note I've ever read in my entire life. And if you guys want, you can follow at @AdelineMorin_fan20 because she is the cutest human being in the entire planet. And I love her so much. And her parents were at the showcase and like her brother was like falling asleep on her dad. And I'm like, ah, you're like the cutest human being ever. And she's like, I found your videos through Chloe Couture's channel. I'm like, let me just read a little portion of this to you. She said, go subscribe to your channel. And at the time I was thinking, what does that mean? But I asked my dad what it meant. And by one subscribing to Chloe's channel, I went straight to yours. So yeah, when I looked at your Instagram, you were located in Manchester, England. I screamed, Adeline Morin's in the UK. And luckily my dad booked tickets. It doesn't seem that exciting, but it's so to me. I'm gonna cry. She's so cute. I'm actually not crying. You know what? I am crying. I am crying because of this. Also crying because of the bath bombs. It's like getting my eye. But I think that it's appropriate if we end the vlog in the bathtub with the Ariana Grande inspired goddess ballistic.
How do you turn this bath on?
Ah! Here we go.
We're playing the vibes. We're putting it in the bath. First time ever in the bath.
Wow, that was everything. And then guess when we're done, you believe God is the one. Hey, good morning and happy September 25th. Just arrived in the beautiful London. I'm so excited. This is our one and only day in London. Well, we stay overnight. We leave tomorrow in the afternoon-ish. I'm so excited. I'm here with Lush. We have the whole day basically to ourselves. We're just gonna go to the Oxford Street and see the Lush store, and then the whole day we have to ourselves. I'm not sure what I wanna do. I kinda wanna do like some touristy stuff, like go see Big Ben. I don't know, go see... Ah, the
But I just said bye to Rosie at the train station. She went off. She lives a little bit outside of London to go to see her mom and dad. She's gonna meet with them and then go home. But Rosie, I know you're watching this because you edit this. I love you so much. Thank you so much for spending the weekend with me. I love you. Yeah, insert clips of me and Rosie now. But yeah, I'm kind of late, so I'm gonna go to Oxford Street. Here's my outfit of the day. I'm wearing my over-the-knee boots, which I thought were very fall, with my Girl Sporting Girls hoodie. I'm wearing this in a large. You guys always ask me what size I use, or what size I wear every single time I wear it. So this one's a large, and I like to wear it for whenever I go wear it for pajamas or wear it as a dress. And then I'm wearing this hat. I think it's from Cotton On, and it was a couple, I think it was like 10 bucks. And my one designer bag, hello! I wear it with like every outfit. But girl, tip of the day, if you're gonna buy anything expensive or designer, buy either a purse, buy either shoes, or any sort of accessory. Don't buy like a clothing, like a hoodie or something like that, because purses you can use every single day and reuse and reuse and reuse. Whereas shirts, you have to like wash it. You know, it's weird if you wear the same shirt like 5 days in a row. Whereas it's not weird if you wear your purse 5 days in a row, or your shoes 5 days in a row. So tip of the day, if you're gonna buy a designer item. But yeah, Oxford Street is just basically a shopping street, and they have a really, really big Lush. I'm pretty sure, I'm not 100%, but I'm pretty sure it has the biggest Lush in the entire world. Let's go. Look at this yellow aesthetic. Ooh. Oh my god, you could literally see where I sat in the bed. Okay, time to go. By the way, aesthetic goals.
Looking around at the biggest Lush store in the entire world, and then we're off to go explore and visit all the things to do in London. Yeah, my hair is really frizzy right now. I got my stuff. You got your stuff?
Yeah, I got a bunch of stuff.
Shelby's here.
Carpo. Nicole really wanted to go here.
I'm not eating chocolate.
We're skinny legends over here.
Wow. Look at that cup. Everything's so fancy. I think I want to get this for my mom.
I got iced regular latte because they don't have syrups. And then this tea for my mom.
Oh my.
Okay, this is so bright! Guys, Nicole and I are being so spontaneous. We might get wicked tickets.
What are we doing Nicole's with never, our lives?
Nicole's never watched it either before. And she does all the songs. Oh my god. Hello, Voldemort here. We're at Piccadilly Circus. Look how beautiful it is here. The sky is so perfect. It's like angelic right now. I also just bought tickets to Wicked, and I'm scared to show you because I'm scared that someone's gonna snatch it out of my hands because we're in the city and it's very hectic here, but got tickets to Wicked.
Adeline's got tickets to Wicked, yes!
Off the green.
Oh, thank you. I tried to try defying gravity.
Bring, bring. Hello. We're just at the... I'm so touristy.
Okay, we should have done this over this because that's class and Nicole went like that.
I got a patch for my suitcase.
Loving it, loving it.
So this is Trafalgar Square, and one of the Harry Potter premieres like happened through here, so they like shut the place down. They're all walking the red carpet, and they filmed things here before too.
Okay, this is Trafalgar Square, Trafalgar Square, Trafalgar Square. Beep, 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 bop. The National Gallery as well. Fun fact, all of the museums here, I think in the UK, are free. Are free in the
yeah,
UK?
They are.
Yeah, so we could just walk in and get knowledge for free. Also, there's
the Canadian Embassy.
The Canadian High Commission. I'm crying because I love Canada. I love being Canadian.
Oh, like Canada, Egypt. Our home and native land.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my god. I just ran into the beautiful Kayla. She's so amazing. She said she watches my videos. So go follow her. What's your username on Instagram?
At Kayla.floor.
Mm-hmm. Go follow her. She's so cute. Okay, so you see all those people.
You see all those people right there?
Oh, and there?
Like those children.
Little world children over there. I don't know how they got up. It was a struggle with me. I wish I was vlogging it. I was literally like, like climbing as if, you know when you're in a pool, you have to be like, and like use your leg to get up. And then also I had to scale around the lion. Bro, I don't know how those kids are up there. I could barely do it and I'm wearing heels. Look at back to the hotel I'm about to go see. Wicked!
It's my first time seeing in so many years.
Wicked! I made it! Look at how beautiful it is.
This is way bigger than the one in Toronto.
Look at the washroom's green. Look at that. It's so beautiful. This is so amazing and beautiful.
I got some merch. I just got a hoodie or a sweater, jacket. Thank you, my jigger.
Half time right now. Oh my God, this is so beautiful. Here's my seat.
It is so good. Like, so good, and everyone has a British accent. Low key living.
Amazing, I was crying.
I don't want to leave. It was so good.
That was an experience. I don't even know
what to say.
It was so much better than I remember watching it the first time. Look at what's over there. Look at it.
This is like magic. This is literally Disney.
Today's vlog. Today's tip of the day goes to Tabby Yacker Nick on Instagram. She just screenshotted one of the quotes that was at the Lush showcase, and it says, it's not really a tip of the day, it's more of like empowering words and positive vibes. It says, empowered, you're feeling confident, in control, calm and collected, you can achieve what you want to, good things will come to you, and you can let go of doubt and move forwards. I love that it's such positive vibes, and I don't know, just reading it made me happy, and I hope that by you listening to it, it makes you happy. And then today's merch shot of the day, you can't really see it, but it goes to Brogue Anderson and Yancy Yamelet. I hope I said her name right, but she's like so cute. Okay, girl. I hope you guys have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day. I'll see you guys in my next daily vlog tomorrow. Okay, bye.